A, B, C, D, E, F, G. Why don't I know my alphabet-y? Hello everyone and welcome back to Piranha Bites, your weekly comic book update. My name's David, also known as the Emissary of Hell, and I will be running you through the number ones and other significant issues of the week. Starting with Marvel, as always. Avengers Beyond number one. This is a follow-up to All Out Avengers, which has the same creative team, Derek Landy and Greg Land. I think it might technically be a follow-up to Defenders Beyond as well, and maybe Monica Rambeau, Photon? Bit unclear on that one. The Beyonder's been about recently, he's been about. But it essentially acts as a follow-up to All Out Avengers, so if you read that, get on this. Betsy Braddock, Captain Britain number two. I guess Captain Carter counts as a Captain Britain? Right? Right? Betsy and the rest of the Captain Britain Corps, also Rachel Summers is there, which is kind of cool. They're all in trouble. And read on to find out the trouble. Clobber in Time, number one. From the covers that have been solicited so far, the ones that we've seen, it just seems to be the Thing teaming up with different Marvel heroes, and honestly, cool. I'm into that. The Thing's always had a really unique sense of humor around him, so yeah, why not do a team-up book? I mean, he's sort of pioneered the Marvel team-up book anyway, so yeah, cool. It's Jeff! The one-shot. It's a digital-only comic. Now it's being published in its entirety in a one-shot issue. So this is a great one for the kids. Honestly, it's just a great, fun read for anyone. Star Wars Jabba's Palace one-shot. I think its full name is Return of the Jedi Jabba's Palace, so you can probably tell where it fits into the timeline. It's always nice to see something from that time period, especially like a stylized thing like this. It's even better when they stop expanding the lore. But necessary reading for any Star Wars fan right here. Venom Lethal Protector 2, number one. I've said it before and I'll say it again, the fact that David Michelinie is still writing and still making decent comics is frankly impressive. So Lethal Protector 1 last year was a huge hit. I can't wait to see what Lethal Protector 2 does. I really enjoyed the first one. I'm probably going to give this a try as well. X-Men Unforgiven one shot. It's part two of the Unforgiven story. Part one is Spider-Man. Yes, we do still have copies. So this little story seems to be dealing with like a group of do-gooder vampires, which is a pretty unique concept in itself. It's not just Blade anymore. Could be an interesting story. It could end up producing something interesting. I liked Spider-Man. Haven't read this one yet, but I liked Spider-Man. So yeah, give it a whirl. Moving on to Detective Comics. DC Ruby number two. I thought we'd already done this with Justice League Ruby, but apparently we're going for another round. Anyone who's a fan of Rooster Teeth's Ruby, give this a shout. Detective Comics 1070. There's nothing particularly noteworthy about this issue. I just really, really like the cover, so it's in the video. Also, this entire run, headed by Ram V, has just been really, really good. So everyone needs to read this. Gotham City Year One, number six. This is the last issue of Gotham City Year One. This kind of book is what Tom King does best. Almost like I don't know how to put it, like a crime book with a superhero spin on it. Almost like a crime noir type thing, but people can fly. So stuff like Rorschach, Strange Adventures. I mean, Sheriff of Babylon is technically a war crime noir, but it technically fits. Omega Men, like so much of Tom King's work is based around this concept. And yeah, it's something he does really, really well. This is no exception. This was blinding. Love having Phil Hester do any art of any description. Just reminds me that he did Green Arrow and I get a bit happy. When this one comes out as a trade, this is 100% worth your time. Yeah, boy. Unstoppable Doom Patrol number one. Of seven now, they've added an extra issue before it even came out, which is just like, that's such a Doom Patrol thing to do. I have read this one, and it does not disappoint me in the slightest. It is so good. Comparing it to the last run, the Gerard Way and Nick Darrington run, it's just as good, if not. I'm not going to say that, that's sacrilege. It's just as good. Chris Burnham is a great artist, great choice for this. And Dennis Colvert, can't say I've read anything he's done before, but yeah, he knocks it out of the park with this. Really, 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 really loved this. Waller vs. Wildstorm, number one. DC are kind of leaning back into the Wildstorm universe a bit, and that's kind of cool to see. Like, the new Wildcats title by Matthew Rosenberg has been a lesson in why we should hate Grifter. It's been really cool so far. Please, DC, lean back into Wildstorm properly. It would be so, so good. For the indies this week, The Ambassadors number one from Image. Any comic book drawn by Frank Quitely is just worth the time. It's worth the read, always. And obviously, we all know who Mark Miller is. There's no reason not to read this. None at all. From Dark Horse, Lady Baltimore, the dream of... God, I'm so useless with names. Ikelos? Lady Baltimore, the dream of Ikelos. It's a one-shot. From Dynamite, Rocket Man, and Rocket Girl. It's just a one-shot. It looks like fun. I don't know much about these characters. I don't know if they're new, or I don't know like if they're legacy characters or anything. But this looked like fun. Give it a whirl. And for new trades, Guardians of the Galaxy by Donny Cates, complete collection. Donny Cates' Guardians of the Galaxy was an experience. Any run that starts off with Thanos is coming back from the dead, you're going to want to read that. We all know that Cates is fantastic at cosmic stuff. You just need to read The Death of the Inhumans to know that. And Thanos wins. And his Guardians run is absolutely no exception to that. This copy is spoken for. However, we do have more. And from Image, It's Lonely at the Center of the Earth by Zoe Thorogood. I have finally managed to get this in. It has been a struggle, but I finally managed to get this in. It's a autobiographical account of life during the pandemic with some artistic license, and it's really, really good. It's good in the same way that the Many Deaths of Layla Starr is good. It's not a large story, it's not full of action, it's just an emotionally complicated ride through someone's life, and it's really cool. Can't say enough good things about this book. Anyway, that's going to be all from me this week. Please make sure to subscribe to our newsletter to get a full list of what came out this week. I really just go through the number ones and everything else that looks interesting. So if you want a full list, subscribe to our newsletter. Thanks very much, and I will see you next week for more brand new comics. Piranha.